Mine's big paper, what's big print.
What you'll see is this is actual to date. So we, I don't have, and it's not even updated. Like I said, God bless Caroline, she gave me items, but she gave it to me yesterday afternoon, so I don't have a chance to update my updates. So we have a lot of the journal.
One thing that she did say.
I don't know, but I think,
And then Renee can get.
So it's engine is up to date.
Is that correct?
Or it's been 40, some of the stuff.
We have home care for
1975.
No, but what I did notice, and when I have a question for her.
But, that's, I don't think that's great.
No, I think she's be the one of the other.
So she.
Is that the alleys?
Yeah.
So that would be a hundred.
If she's just drawing something at.
Or it's $105. Or are you talking about?
And that would add.
And that's what I got, $45.
And so that would be one. I have to assume that bigger numbers are.
So that's $145, yeah.
And so that's what we need to cover.
Up to here, through the next.
Because I have three campers, but one is pretty shady, one is not taking advantage of it.
So after that, I don't see any large numbers that would indicate it was a sports.
Hi, how was it happening?
It was awesome.
Did you have large numbers?
Exactly.
Because I came.
It did, yeah. It was really.
So you put them up there.
We might have larger numbers after.
See, June would be, I would say.
Yeah, okay.
Or we think one or two more. I'd have to go back and look to see when the last installments are taken, but I think it's somewhere in July.
And that's it, right? Okay, see, that might be what she was telling me about, then, she said some of the money is not showing in sports, that she might be talking about. I forgot we were doing installment plans. So that could be it, but I think she's.
And she's probably also talking about the people who paid or did the big registrations who were not eligible.
Yeah.
She may be indicating that.
So this was okay, so like they're doing paid registrations.
This is not necessarily.
We offered, long as they were paying.
Still,
I don't even know how they did it.
So they are.
Four or two.
I mean, so, cool. She gave me this.
Well, that's very.
I pushed the tool to the side.
Okay.
Well, that's could be part of it.
Oh, no, I have it in later.
Yeah.
I don't know what's coming along.
So this is gone or.
Cool, we want.
And then.
Okay.
So, yeah, write this number down. Because we really paid $07 is what we really paid. It is, it's so amazing. We gotta go back there just for that.
I know.
And Hilltop was $330.
That's an actual registration. So that is about $100 cheaper than.
Okay, so what's next?
This is where we should end at the link, at the end, if everybody's paid every dime that they go.
So, and where is it going?
This number here is based on the projected.
So we're saying, okay, the grand total.
That we would have paid.
Yeah.
And I, yeah, we're all chit-chatting, sorry, we're figuring out.
Okay.
We both have been doing the.
So then we have team that.
Team camp budgets, and I do mine by hand. And then she does it by the computer, and then we try to see how close we get to actually coming together.
Yeah, and to be honest, registration for only $15.
Yeah.
So I don't know about that, but I won't have until after tonight. I will work on it, cover picture.
Okay.
And the actual for.
As far as anticipated versus.
Water country was three, there was like 342.88.
You won't be exact.
343.
Yeah, so I wrote.
Plus three bucks.
I mean, it was just.
So put it in the box.
Yeah, so I didn't do all that, but I didn't do that. So I did my, like, time to start moving on your round.
So that's why I had a separate.
Well, yeah.
Just kind of. Over.
So this is my.
Because I put an extra that we looked at.
No, but again, so this is.
That's what we should be, that's not up to date.
Yes, because I didn't take this out yet.
Okay.
So this would be a segment of 265.
Everybody got
another plan. Yeah, we had a plan.
We
so then Jay comes
been a long time.
So I know we got a lot to talk about, I can tell. I kind of like Brittany to go first, so we can get an update on how the campus is going.
Kids are loving it. They're fine. They actually want more free time, which we've been leaving in, but so we're averaging about $200 each week per pizza.
Profit and risk.
That's good.
That's
good
news.
That's
yeah.
Awesome. That's actually impressive.
Itch.
I have them Wednesdays or
yes, Wednesdays.
My husband dropped off Chris for the first time today. He's making a pizza.
Yeah. And he's like, what do I do with this?
Yeah. So he called me this afternoon. He's like, you guys are overcharging for pizza because it's Little Caesars. I said, no, we're not.
Target today, that's why I dropped off in that request weeks ago, and
and I have not heard back. And last year they gave us a $50 gift card. The person that gave us the gift card last year is out, so they left a note. The person had left his bay, and I should be hearing soon from Target, and we can run over there and get you more stuff from Target Ice Pops. Paper plates, I think that was on your list. Do you still need
those? I got some at Hanford. We'll always need some because pizza every week. So,
the pizza place doesn't give you those?
No. They did the first week, and then they realized I kept coming back, and they were like, no more pizza.
So, we had discussed at our meeting earlier this year that we were going to do delivery. That you guys are going to Little Caesars.
It's just me.
Okay.
Yeah, it takes 10 minutes.
So, I just wondered why that had changed, because Supos in Dover will deliver to us, and they have a bigger pizza, and they'll cut it into 12 slices.
I'm just making more money off of Little Caesars than I thought we would on Supos.
Okay.
Even with the delivery, then if they're delivering, they're going to want a tip.
If it's working and nobody's complaining or making a profit, then it's going to be reasonable.
So gummies, what are gummies?
Like little Welch's. Is there anything that you need from us that we can help you with right now?
Clarification on what I can and can't do with the approvals of everything.
It's expenses, really. Yeah.
It's everything. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
If anything, whoever's going out to Live has to run it for the chairs tonight. So we are overspent. We don't have any funds to pay the balance through the town budget. So we have to be extremely careful, and it has to be.
But like the bigger ticket items need to go via to you, but not the snack stuff, right? Is that if it were reselling
if
it?
If you resell, no. Where do you get your money from? Are you taking it from the box and going buying more product? What do you? How does that work?
So everything so far has been donated, except for even Hanford was donated. So that even the trip that I just did a couple days ago was donated from Hanford.
Yeah.
So I haven't personally gotten an info snack check yet.
Okay.
And it's not something that Caroline wants us to do anyways, which is take money from the cash.
You know what, that's why I was asking. Definitely. So, it definitely has to go through the chair and myself for the select board to say whether or not such a good talk.
Because right now we're supplies, which includes anything we need for a snack shop. We're 520 over right now.
Mm-hmm.
So, definitely bring it to us. We'll be happy to seek out more donations or go get what we need for that, for sure.
Is that what the sales that we have?
No, I don't think they put any support in there.
Okay.
What was the name? Sorry.
She was asking if you had input what was being made in the snack truck. That's not on there yet. Right?
No, I had a question about that. When Caroline inputs sales, rec sales,
I have an index card. Kelly saw this process the other day. So I have an index card. I write the date. I write the total of money in the bank. Mm-hmm. And then I break it down into whether it's a registration, snack, pizza. And then I try to do shirts, but I haven't had time to count shirts. So sometimes shirts get mixed in with snack, but all she tells me is that she's putting a registration in sales. So pizza, snack, and shirts would be under sales, and then everything else would be in registration.
Okay. Because there was a $550 drop on 710. Does that sound familiar to you?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's...
Yeah.
All right.
So how are you paying for the pizza?
The kids are paying me in the morning, getting an invoice from them, handing it to Caroline.
And Caroline paying them directly?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay.
I don't think I'm going to have I only have two invoices for her pizza because one was the Luke Jones, so I didn't have time to come down. And then one from last week, and she wasn't here. Right. And I'm handing those to her tomorrow.
So pizza's invoiced.
Yep.
So that's not probably out there yet.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm just putting it in.
Since we're talking about snack, and Denise, I'm going to talk to you about it. So my daughter did a UNH soccer camp, and I don't know if we want to go there, but I want to tell you what their process is. You paid money in advance for snacks, and they had it in $5 and $10 increments, and it said in big bold writing when you signed up, no refunds will be issued. So that might be something, because that is going to be a nightmare for Caroline at the end of the summer if she has to write checks out to 60 families or 65. I mean, at least it makes parents kind of think, oh, how much money should I put on this card right now?
That's a really good idea.
Or even on a weekly basis, you can put money down, right? It doesn't have to be.
Right, you can bring in money at any time, right?
Just add it to the card. Yeah.
But so I just, so that might be very helpful for, I mean, I was surprised by it, but then, of course, at the end of the, I was texting Shelby when it was time to go. I'm like, do you have any more money on that snack? I'm like, go get an extra snack, bring it home with you. But
see, I kind of like the refund because I put $20 down the first week. My kid has spent $1 in the snack check, and that's it. He's been there for 2 weeks.
Okay, well, you need to get your kid eating.
I dropped him off one day, and I said, snack check's going to be open in 15 minutes. Get over here. You haven't had breakfast yet. And figuring he'd spend $2 or $3 yeah. getting breakfast. And he goes, I pick him up at lunchtime that day. And he, did you eat? No, Mommy, I decided I wasn't hungry. Really? I told you, go get a snack. And like,
well, see, next time you might put $10 down.
The next meeting is going to be solely based on that. I'm going to do research and look for different ways that we can run things for next year. If there is any, I'm sure there will be. But there's always room for improvement, right? So we can talk about that next meeting. If you want to hold it aside, or something needs to be addressed right now, then we can certainly
do
that.
Hold on to that. So.
Okay.
Yeah. I was telling Brittany that one thing that I noticed is I work the summer program in the school. And so going down to get kids, and like, you always get all these kids coming up and giving you a hug and saying hi. Not this year. I think they're all occupied. Mm-hmm. So they're busy. They're not, then the parent is walking through. They don't need to run up and do that anymore. Yeah. So I think that's great.
Mm-hmm. I like the comment that Jody sent along.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
the gentleman that
the new dentist, yeah.
Yeah, that's really nice.
Before, I thought he was supposed to be my chops. I thought they had already, like, said who I was and stuff. And
it wasn't. That's nice.
Do you have any intention of just sending home something at the end of the year, like a survey of how it was and what they liked, what they didn't like?
Last year, the constant contact was the same thing. We'll just look at the questions, maybe reformulate the question based on things that may have happened this year.
Okay.
We did the parents and we did the staff.
Okay. Good.
So we'll do that. And Brittany, you can help me. What else? Anything else again?
So Kathy just asked about teen camp. Like, I think it's going great, but like I'm there too. So you know, it's kind of the kids when they first started. You know, I think our first trip. parents are making you do this. We're like, but you know, they, I mean, they're, most of them are staying there on the fun. You know, they're doing, they're busy and they're tired. Like half of the van is asleep on the drive home today. Like, they're tired. So, I think it's great. I'm a little biased to that.
And Joe, today is the last day for teen camp, so you can close it out.
I know.
Registration. We're all in. No more registrations.
I think we just have seven from, we just have seven next week and seven week seven. So it's a smaller, we, those 2 weeks were pretty, were small on the initial, but you know, this week we had 14, that was busy. Last week was 10. The week before that was 10. And our first week was 12. Second week was 8. So.
Have you heard any parents?
Yes.
The last two that signed up will be one.
Right.
So I had to fix that today. So that's fixed in the software. Because then you have an unpaid kid that doesn't exist. So, So that your seven next week includes it?
Yes.
Okay.
So I need to, yeah.
And next week was the week when we first started this, looking at the numbers. We were thinking about canceling because I only had three kids registered. And we kept it open. And a few more signed up, and it's making it more viable.
That's
great.
And yeah, if you wanna, so between Celia and myself, we've been really trying to keep track of the whole money situation with Teen Camp. So I ran stuff just yesterday with the change in some of the kids and some of our. We're putting in money now instead of guessing on what we're paying for some things. We got a great deal on from Take Flight. I don't know how that ended up happening because that was going to be our huge expense. That was like an 80, we thought that was going to be $82 a kid. And they charge us $258 for it. I have no idea why.
So originally we for Take Flight, we had...
It was like our biggest expense. It was like $600 and something, I think.
We had budgeted based on eight kids, $656.
Yeah.
So based on their price on the website.
And they charged us $258.
And did
they have a ball? They had a blast. It was great. They did zip lining and the ropes course. So they did the full day. So they asked, they gave us, I know, a huge discount because we were tax exempt. And we, so that was, that really was helping us. But I... So I figured out that we're about $1,900 in the plus. So
for Teen Camp?
Yes.
Aww.
So with me driving, that saved a lot of money. But like I said, it was a lot of fun. So I wasn't going to drive. Celia had a little bit less, but I think we're kind of coming together.
Yeah.
On that, so
there was and two invoices from Take Flight, and I guess they got paid by Caroline, and one of them is being refunded. So I have both the invoices in there, so that's part of the difference.
Yeah.
What was invoiced versus what was actually paid.
Yeah.
If
I
that
just,
makes sense.
I've just been trying to take the what we're just not. We actually even went to the movies on Monday, so we took a bad weather day and went to the movies at Smitty's on Monday. And that hasn't even, that hasn't really come into our budget either. So.
And well, like Kelly
I
said,
went to the movies too.
Between what we budgeted as the highest possible price, or we thought was going to be the highest possible price, and what we've actually come in at, we're ahead than what we projected for our highest totals, probably.
Oh.
Does this reflect the supplies, the $293.99?
Yeah.
So there's already
So on. Put that, yeah, we'll put that right in the team.
Okay.
Supplies.
So we'll take that out of
ours.
Because we were like $300 ahead according to my numbers based on what we had budgeted and what we had spent. And with the deals, that's covered.
Oh, yeah, we have plenty of money.
And
so,
plenty of money. I have another question. Well, when you're done, I have another question.
Yeah.
Go ahead. So this one, right, I know that we talked about and you'll have to refresh my memory, doubling up buses. I can't remember what trips they were, but are there trips where you guys can absorb some of those buses, do you think? Or
well,
the cost?
We can absorb, but based on even my numbers, we could absorb 6 buses.
Yeah.
With Kelly's numbers, you could do 7 or 8.
Okay. We'll try to come to a better conclusion, but I mean, yeah.
So if that's the case, you and I can just be in constant contact about the first student invoices and which ones you'll take and which ones I'll take.
Yeah.
Okay.
But you know that 2 of them are netting together. So,
right.
I mean, it really isn't. I mean, if you're trying to do it for the sake of trying to figure out what team actually costs,
right.
As long as the teams go on those buses.
Right.
Yes. They did.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
So if that's the case, then yeah, that would be good to. So you can have it for planning next year.
Yeah,
but
absolutely.
They do net together, so I mean,
yeah, that I'm not as much concerned about as I am keeping track of it for next year so that we can base tuition off of that or budget better off of that.
And we talked, you touched upon this coming in, but Kelly has offered to drive, and she originally was going to drive 4, and she drove, so far she's driven, scheduled to drive 6 times because she took them on Monday to the movies, which was not a scheduled bus day, and then she took them to Hilltop in Dover, or Summersworth, instead of taking a bus over there. So that's $1,500 that we've saved in bus fees, and she has not asked for reimbursement for gas. Can she do that now? Or is that something should consider?
I mean, you send it, it's fine. You know, I mean, there's a per diem per miles or whatever. I mean,
I don't know. I think the state of New Hampshire shows reimbursement is either 57 and 59 cents. If you're talking about mileage reimbursement.
Yeah, I'm just saying,
yeah.
I mean, she's using her own vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, I don't have a problem with her getting mileage or paying a gas.
I guess that my only feeling was is if there was money, I would take it. If not, then I would be.
Yeah.
It would be fine. So maybe we do.
But you do have money in team.
Yes.
But well, it's going to help the other, unfortunately, with that other issue.
Right. Right.
But so it's in all fairness, you're saving us a lot of money.
Yeah.
So I mean, I don't have a problem with it.
Yeah.
If you come up with whatever way you want to do it.
Like, to me, like, to drive when I drove to Hilltop, like, that's, like, I wouldn't even bother with, you know.
Yeah, but if you're
like
going to Candy Lake or Candy Lake,
yeah.
That's, you know.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Consider it, and you decide what to do yourself.
Okay.
I just wanted to throw
I'll think about it. I'll let you know if I'm broke at the end of summer.
So, can I?
But thank you. I thank you.
Ask a question? Or a couple of questions. Grant setup. We have the Mount Washington Observatory coming in. That's $431 on August 1st out of the 1,000 that we got. And then we were invoiced for that, and it should have gone to the select board by email, Caroline, and it came to the rec committee, so I forwarded it on to Caroline so she could get the check ready or whatever.
Yeah.
And the select board student.
I got it. I don't know if they did. I thought it was went to me, but I can check and see if it did.
I sent out a second one that went to the select board. I don't know if you got it the second time. We have 8:15 scheduled for the STEM in the summer for 3 hours. And that is 4th graders through 8th graders, or 4th through 10th. That's $150 for 3 hours. So we had budgeted $500 for him. Talking to Brittany, August 8th is that a good time frame I needed from you, confirmation. 9:30 to 12:30, 10 to 1, what do you want to do? $500. So if I schedule him for 8:15, it's 150. He's gonna come in. I have to book it 9:30 to 12:30. I told him tentatively we were gonna book that morning. So that'll bring us up to 300. He can come in for a third date, and that'll bring us to 450. Or if we can figure it out, or I don't know, he does things all the way up to like 10 or 12th grade. Do we want it? I don't know if there's time in the teen camp to do it or not do it. Maybe a question for Brittany.
So the only thing I think of teen camp is that unfortunately you can project that. It'd be like if we could somehow take a rainy day, you know, because we really were scrambling for today. If we had to cancel today's trip on what to do for a rainy day, but that's not really a possibility with him. Right?
Also, I forgot. I have to be out of the art room on the 8th. And then they are cleaning the gym floors on the 15th. So after he leaves, bye. So I'm trying to find space for team to do it on a Friday. It's not going to work in the next couple of weeks.
Because that would be the only time we could do it on Fridays in the morning. And then of course, we can. And you told me Friday mornings are hard because they're compressed anyway for the pool. So I don't know. I can go back to the grantor, bank, and ask them what they would like us to do with our extra money. Or we could try and schedule something outside of camp.
Or I mean, talk about maybe Family Day and have it be sponsored by the Red Committee and have it doing something on Family Day.
Okay.
Well, like the STEM guy on Family Day.
Yeah. See, I mean, it would be, he could pick a time any time from 12 to 4. But if you wanted to, that's an option, but it would be sponsored by you guys, not by Family Day. Mm-hmm. So you get the recognition, or the bank gets the recognition of their being sponsored. Just have a sign up there that this is who's sponsoring this, you know. But it's still part of children's activities in the rec, in some fashion. So I don't think that would be something that they would object to.
Because my suggestion in an email had been, do we try and schedule it for a weekend or an evening and open it up to the public?
Yeah.
And have it be a rec sponsored event, and then we could open it up first, or send an email to all of our families that were in camp and say, if you weren't able to make it, you can sign up for it here.
Does he have a limit?
For the programs he's doing with them, it's 16.
Okay.
Does
this have to be indoor or outdoor?
I can forward you an email. But I know the Mount Washington would like to start outdoors, and they would like an open space. I told them to look around when they got there and to talk to you. They would like to talk about the weather and look up the clouds. I told them the playground is there, but they can go on the soccer field. They could go down by the trees. They could use where the trees are, and maybe with your permission, if it was okay, they might be able to use the front yard. I wasn't sure.
I'm not sure either.
The STEM and the summer guy wants, he did say an indoor area and an outdoor area, and a sloped area. So I don't know if the natural terrain will be okay, or if he'll want to use the stairs and the hallway or what. Because for the downhill derby, they might be racing, like they're going to build a car and race it. Something like do that.
I don't think they can find slopes that side. There's by the kindergarten, it's
Super.
Mm-hmm. And then in the playground is in the soccer field. It's, half of the soccer field.
You can get back to me if you want to be part of Family Day.
That grant was only for, is that what we asked for?
It was only him, right?
Okay.
It was the Mount Washington Observatory.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was STEM in the summer, 500 for each of those, 500 for Chris Pepoulos, the
Trick Bike Rider and Anti-Bullying Talk, but Brittany contacted him and he was not available. So,
so it was $1,500?
It was $1,000 is what we were awarded.
Okay.
So.
I was just kind of wondering about the Doodlebugs thing, like if there's money left over, we couldn't do that, because that grant didn't come through, right?
Those grants did. So we applied for 4 grants. We've heard from 2 of them.
Rejected.
Yep, the Eastern Bank, we were rejected. The Newberry Savings Bank, we got $1,000 from. Optimal Bank, they were supposed to have a decision for us June 15th, and we haven't heard. So I need to reach out to
June 15th.
Yes. I need to, they said when I applied it was a long shot, because they had just moved into Leaks Crossing at Dover. So they were not optimistic when we applied. So that one, I would not be surprised if we were denied from two. And then waiting to hear about goods, gift cards from Dick's Sporting Goods.
Yeah.
And I did reach out to Walmart and we're waiting to hear from them. And even today when I went down to BJ's, I asked them and they are 6 to 8 weeks out, so it wouldn't be beneficial for this year, but next year we can consider them and they would do $25 to $50 on a gift card or a donation of goods.
So Doodlebugs is out this year, huh?
Yep.
Doodlebugs
and Wentworth House. Because those were 2 covered both in the Eastern Bank and the Altima Bank, the way they were written.
Yeah.
Was to cover those.
So you don't think that you can use the other money from the grant for some of that? The other grant? I mean, it's still an enrichment program that's coming through.
I mean, I have a contact name for the Newberry Savings Bank, and I will reach out to her. I reached out to her and asked her a question when we first got the money, and I have not heard back from her, but I will reach out to her again.
I mean, if you, you know, someone local,
yeah,
that you know, could do the program, I would ask the question. Tell them that, you know, the person that you were going to have the grant to is no longer available. Can we do this person instead?
And then my other
things are strong about the things you can do as long as it's for your program.
Right.
Some kind of, that's what I would think.
And,
right.
Originally, I was talking to another gentleman in the bank who's the head of the grant program, and then he hands it off to someone else when he's done. So, and when I talked to him around July 4th, he's like, I'm like, do we need pictures? Do we need thank you? Do you need any sort of verification about how we use this money? And he said, we do not need any verification on how you use your money. We have faith that you will use it as you said you will use it.
So they're kind of hoping that they're probably a change in the program isn't going to be a problem,
right,
as much as not doing the program and banking the money.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They want you to do something with
right.
that money, but I bet you could easily change the program.
Oh.
So if you want to do that, that's fine.
I don't know if there would be enough money if we're doing the thing.
Oh, you mean the Doodle Bugs?
Yeah.
Because she's looking at $5 to $10 a child to do the class. So
that would be at least 5 on one of these weeks.
Yeah, it depends on the weeks, right? And she would be able to come right into us. But I did start.
But I'm also out of that art room in like a week and a half.
Well,
so
she did use the gym last year.
Yeah, she had the gym too. But
yeah,
that's
a week
later,
gym,
right?
A week
later. Why do you have to be out of the art room?
She did do the gym last year, so she didn't have a problem. Doodlebug did not have a problem using the gym. But I was going to say, I did start looking at other grant, local grant vendors for next year, coming up with a date. And it was suggested that we come up with a calendar and try and do it earlier in the season so that when camp starts, we know what funds we have available.
I had that written down.
Yeah, I did as well. I'm not sure. For sure. It takes time to get approvals.
Yeah.
You know, they may be spring approvals versus summer approvals, and you could head up on the spring one and knowing that you're going to be, you know, so it's definitely a strong summer.
Get on that, Celia.
By the hour,
right?
You're going to Alcoya,
right?
Yeah.
But But at this point, I think we've had so many cancellations that.
Just as we can save $500 for not going on.
Right, right. So there should be, in theory, there should be bus money available.
We're going to take it. And you already have the passes. If you haven't used them, so you already have those.
Right.
So then, right, it's just the bus cost.
So maybe, so the 16th is a Thursday, is that correct? So maybe we try to do that sooner than later and try and make that plan to go someplace.
Yeah.
Even if it doesn't rain.
Yeah. I mean, we could do outside activities all day anyways, but it's going to just be easier because we'll
right.
have to try to do everything else.
And that way, if Friday is the rainy day, then that's a little more day.
Okay, well, before I give any kind of authorization, I need to know what the numbers are.
Right.
Bottom line. Mm-hmm. So I will get back to you on that, okay?
Yeah.
Okay. The date, does that continue again?
16.
And the 18th? Well,
17. Well, 17. So the 17th it has already been budgeted in because it's a pool day, so it would be a half of a bus day. So.
So you said instead of going to the pool, you're going to go to the car and going to train? Or no?
Well, you're only doing.
Right. I'm wondering, is there a Garrison at Players on the corner? I wonder if they'd be willing to open up, even for a minimal fee, to let us borrow their facility for half a day. They've got a large room, they've got a dinner on the second floor. It's a possibility.
What do they even do there?
Whatever, I don't know, any sort of activity, if it rains, sometime after it rains.
What about also
Legion? Legion, too, if it rains. They have that big, huge room.
We could contact the Legion and see if we could rent their space for a half day and then just walk the kids down there.
Or just have parents drop them off at the Legion that day or something.
Give them
it's just
kids.
A thought, you know, and just a place to put the kids.
They can walk.
Yeah.
Schools
there. Yeah.
The kids with the Legion, right?
Yeah.
You know,
they've
got
the
big South Park field.
But,
give the parents the option to put kids home that day, or just send them, give them permission for
that day, that one day.
Okay, so what's that question?
Let me do this. Can you give these?
Mine need to get back.
The region.
So do you need to look into the liability rating?
8 weeks.
Of having, going to the region, if there's any, and if there isn't, then we can seriously consider doing it. We're seeking permission to do that for whoever. I wouldn't even contact the American Legion. Is there
a guy in Jen that just passed away, so I don't know. But there's an email, post47@comcast.net, is what his was. I'm hoping someone is covering for.
The other thing is just a committee member who just resigned in the last month is part of the Legion of Custodians. We would reach out to her.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we see that's a contact name.
Yeah. That's how we got our donation from the Legion of Custodians.
A couple of bartenders.
For me, personally, I like the idea of staying somewhere local instead of going on a trip that day. That's just me. And I don't want to tag along, follow you on my car on a field trip with my
other kids. Fun.
I don't want to be alerted to her and my kid run away to come find me. I want him to enjoy camp without me and be focused on what they're saying to them and not what I'm doing.
I think there's a place that would be great, though, if there's enough time to get something organized on their behalf, is talking about theater and, you know, have them go into the upstairs theater room and talk about how it works and, you know, because they do have a kid,
They have a lot of auditions.
Maybe the teenage camp in the summertime, and they do a performance after the end of it. I think that would be a great idea.
I think that would be like
maybe down the road, if it's not this year, maybe think about it for next year. You know, just having someone give them, you know, a tour and what happens. And
last year, my kids went to theater camp there. Mm-hmm. This year, the theater camp starts at age 7, so my kids don't qualify. But I did give them information about the camp, and we were looking for donations last year.
My two oldest went there. They liked it.
Yeah, we went to
theater camp.
Yeah.
They liked it a lot. I've heard a lot of positive about it.
So we ended up going to donations for mine, because they don't start until 7 or 8 here in town. Mm-hmm. So we went to theater camp.
Maybe it's
worth
reaching out.
Maybe
a program for them next year or something.
Yeah. Giving them a new line together. Figure out what they can do, but you know, it could be a great future.
Hey, who wants that job? Kathy?
What?
Yeah, I'll do
it. You want to contact Harrison Players and see if they're willing to work something out with us?
For this year or next year?
For August 16th or 17th.
Of this year and
then
with the possibility
year.
Of next year.
Coordinating something more in depth next year.
I have I have two contacts, and I'll send a human email.
I have that's a lot.
Oh, well, yeah, that's right, he's the president.
Yeah.
But I have one who does the town part of it.
Okay.
So, yeah, perfect. See what he says first.
Okay.
I have a question about CPR. Did we get charged for that?
Yes. I don't know if it's gone through.
Do we know how much?
CPR. What did they charge? Was it 25?
In 2025. I don't know if you've gotten that yet.
Who's what?
20
or
25.
25 per person.
How many people are in the
room? I don't count. I keep counting myself in that. So, 8.
Is it you walked into your classroom?
No, we went to the school.
They went.
The school on their workshop days. The teachers do that.
Did New York do it?
No.
Oh.
McGregor
did it.
Jody, the pool that you bought, how big are they?
And what do you buy?
Because you had asked, and I was like, I don't even know about the pools, but they're, how many are they?
They're pretty big.
Are they like inflatable?
Mm-hmm.
Is there, there's no liability for that, is there, for the pools?
Mm-hmm. They're not that deep, are they?
No.
They're like,
the top of the pool here, but like the water, that's how they get the pools here.
Perfect.
Yeah,
let me show you a picture.
Perfect.
And then
I'll do actual to date, and I'll do projection.
Okay. And then that'll be good to go forward for our half here, first half of the summer. Really? This is our shortest meeting ever.
I'm sure I have more questions.
Yes, Jody.
Do you want to send out the thing about basketball now?
Basketball is that time.
What's happening with basketball? Do tell.
Yeah, I don't know. If you don't have any basketball, that's just that we have to figure out if there's any interest in having a coach. Well, that's not so the bigger problem, and I don't remember if you were here at the last meeting, but I told everybody here that I cannot do what I did last year. So the coordination of a game scheduling is a huge time commitment. So unless actually what I would like to do is meet with the new principal to see what they would like to, because at one point in time, our basketball program was our school program. Mm-hmm. And he's coming in with a gym background, mm-hmm. and maybe we can bring that all back, and we can give that assignment away, which would be awesome. So I can take the lead on that and see what things. I don't know, does anybody here know why that ever stopped being a school program?
Tracy didn't want to do it anymore, right?
Yeah, well, and then...
But it was a school program and they did it?
Kelly Gatham.
They were the volunteers who did it.
Yeah,
they ran it for
Kelly
a long
Gatham
time.
And... she's Kelly Young now. And Loveland did it for a while after Tim.
Mm-hmm.
And then their kids...
But that was not a school program, though. They called it, that was part of a recreation program. Because
I thought that was still the school that Kelly did it.
No, because she did all that stuff. Like, and now that I did it for 1 year, I'm like, oh my goodness, Kelly, I don't know how she did it, because she did it with 14.
Maybe it ended with 10, then. I don't know.
Yeah.
I know that Tim and Tracy ran the program.
They did.
The traveling team program, that's what we're talking about, right?
Right. So at some point in time, it just fell, because I wonder if Tim and Tracy did the scheduling too. So at some point in time, does that go back onto the school? It was like, okay, if somebody at the school can take on that job.
But it isn't really a sponsored event for the school either. It's an after-school program or an after a traveling team type program.
Right.
The school didn't fund that at all.
They were supposed to support
funding by themselves. I mean, they had to raise funds to get their uniforms, and they had to raise funds to do referees and all of that. Nothing came out of the school budget, as far as I remember.
I don't think so. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it was part of the school.
Yeah.
As in, the kids who were on the team were volunteers.
Right.
And I think, and they were able to use the gyms, mm-hmm. you know, with no cost.
And they had a closet where they had all their
their stuff. Yeah.
Or
a couple of years ago, we weren't allowed to store basketballs in there. We weren't allowed to store anything in there. So I don't really know why that became an issue.
Well, I know currently I don't know the space. There's things everywhere.
Well, last year it came under the umbrella of the town, correct, Jody?
Mm-hmm.
Sure,
because that was once the town took it over.
Right.
Town liability.
Right.
And when you're in the school, it's not in school liability. Cause you're in the
right, the big umbrella was covered.
Yeah.
I don't know. I just would put that on Caroline's shoulders, too. Caroline, do you want to call the ADs and get...
She's good and fun.
Well,
just 5 or 10 hours a week. And then during the summer or during basketball, it peaked up more.
Right.
Because that's when you have more duties.
Right.
So I don't know if that's something that'll feasibly work in the near future or not.
There's just too much wrong. There's going to be too much this year. Not even more than. I mean, this year, I'm telling you, at 1.4. It's a lot happening.
And from what I remember, Suzanne had asked us to look, see if we could come up with the extra income to offset it.
Right, right. I mean, it would have to be like, right, it has to be offset it, whether or not that's even possible.
Mm. So my question was, when we discussed at the last meeting about moving the winter money over, and we got clarification after the meeting that winter rent is not to be moved by this group. In the past, we have not, from my recollection, have not offset winter rent. It was put in there as a request before this group came about for Alliant for the, so that $1,000 was never paid out, or that $1,100
never made.
The request was put in by the previous rec committee and never budget put in by the previous rec committee and never paid out. So that money has just carried forward. And
it's
then
a line item, but there, I mean,
so
the expectation, just like summer rec, is for it to be neutral. I mean, you have to raise the funds in order to spend the funds.
No, not for the line item. The line item was town funded.
So that's where my
I agree to disagree with you. If the expectation of rec is to be totally supported.
So my understanding was summer rec had to be totally supported. It was not the same for a bunch of rec. So
at one time they were looking for the liner, which has already been purchased or donated or whatever. That has been done, but then my understanding is that liner is destroyed now, right?
But that was purchased.
Awful.
It was
slices of, or, I don't know if it's because there wasn't enough ice in there and it got cut when it was.
But when it was stored, it was no good.
Yeah.
But I guess my understanding was summer rec had to be sufficiently self-funded. But then, like fireworks for Family Fun Day, the senior programs, and winter rec were town-funded. That was my understanding. And now we have a disagreement whether winter rec of the $1,100 is town funded or self-sufficient.
I'll ask the question, but I'm pretty certain. Family Day is a donation towards fireworks. It's not a program.
And it's town funded.
It always was said it was town funded.
That's what I'm saying.
But I'm saying winter rec is not.
Well, I think the line item we put the $1,100 was put in there
for the liner.
For the liner, and it was never. I don't know. Like
you bought it before.
Right. But
so
we just left it there.
Right.
To carry over.
Right.
So if that is another liner that needs to be purchased, I don't know.
Okay.
And how often do you need to purchase a new liner? But I mean, if we're gonna have a free ice skating rink for people in town, we aren't gonna make any money.
Right. Have this transfer station, guys, collect as you get on.
There's no place to have a concession stand.
I know.
Sell hot chocolate.
Maybe we can double it. So.
Good.
Somebody helps with shit.
So we definitely, so I guess that needs to be clarified. Because, I don't know, with our financial situation as it is right now, there's not going to be any money to pay for a new liner. So.
But for basketball, that comes out of winter rec too. And did the kids pay to be part of the team or no?
They used to.
They did, but I mean, we hardly had any kids. So I don't even know if we ever reconciled whether we were in the plus or the negative on that one for basketball or basketball season.
Winter rec and basketball are combined line. Well, so that money that is in there is for both programs, or shows on the line for $1,100 is for both programs total.
But you're saying we need to, there's no way on the planet that we're raising $1,100 by charging our kids $20 to play basketball. So we're not,
mean, we'd have to charge them for the 8 kids that play.
So how many play?
Well, maybe you'll get more because we didn't have it for so long.
Right.
So then that, you know, and you know, like soon.
Maybe we guys have 8 kids.
If it's more promoted.
Well, that's not true, actually. There might have been
girls.
Yeah, a couple more.
So, like 11. And
a lot more showed up for open gyms, which were free. We did a bunch of open gyms, but there wasn't enough of the other age group to field teams. There was only one age group of third and fourth grade boys that fielded a team. So that was what we did, but half of them now will be aging up to 5-6. But you know, I don't know if there'll be enough. So with the new grouping, I don't know if there'll be enough in the 5-6 boys and in the 3-4 boys to of interest to build a team.
Well, maybe.
Or I don't know if there'll be girls. We sent our girls over to summer's work. They combined a team, and it went really well.
Could we charge for open gym $1 or $2? What the kids come by, or do we want to keep it free?
And sell snacks.
Because they all want to eat snacks.
Well, open gyms don't cost anything. We had all the volunteers coaching, and we got the gym for free, so it's like a wash.
So maybe when you talked about the new principal and his enthusiasm and have a gym background, maybe if we talked with him, he might get a better idea, or maybe he can reinvigorate the whole basketball program, or help reinvigorate it.
Like softball, you want to rally now before they gravitate to Marshall.
Yeah.
What else you want
so maybe
to
the center, maybe the center.
Yeah, well, I got a few other things I need to talk to him about.
Oh, yeah. So. But
hello, just remember who I am. Might have been, I don't know, my years all flowing.
when there were four teams, we had practice time for 3 hours, 4 days a week. We had Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday from 5:30 to 8:30. So why there wasn't time last year?
So maybe that's something that will change as well.
When basketball was going on last year, somebody put on social media about there used to be a program for the little kids to do like skills and stuff like that.
That was done by the Lorians, and that was only the years that they did it. Saturday mornings they did ABC basketball, and that was the Lorians. The school had never had that before that.
Would it be beneficial for somebody like myself who has a younger kid to look into doing that, to feed into the older kids program?
My kids did that at summer work, so I don't know.
I did at summer work.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's available elsewhere.
Yeah.
It can be done.
It's a pretty ball. They do a good job. I don't know. Yeah, there's a lot of kids. It's hard to figure out what programs we should be pulling in when there's others available. Towns right next door to us, you know.
And I know. Even when we had it, it was pretty low key.
Yeah.
I mean, they worked on skills, but it wasn't like a drill. I think it was more of a fun.
Right. Yeah. At that age, you just wanted to run in the middle of the winter.
Yeah.
Right.
And anything.
For the parents, that it's time for having their morning coffee, and
right.
Like
I'm here.
Just past that stage.
Try to. We are more than happy to
run the ball.
You
have a ball too. Maybe
right.
Kick it
because of that. Plus, you have to have so many of those little balls.
Right.
They can't have the regular ball. They have to have the little bitty balls.
Right.
And so you have to buy all the little bitty balls. Some of
the yeah, I don't think we have any.
No.
I think they use regular balls.
So someone's already did that.
Yeah.
So talking about programs, if you had your, totally off the topic, but if you had your brothers, what would you offer in Wallingford that's not already offered?
It's hard to say. I mean, I think basketball is the easiest to offer because there's a gym with a basketball court, you know? Besides that, what else do we have? I used to play on a summer softball team that was a Rollinsford team. It was slow pitch.
Adult?
Or no, it was high school girls, slow pitch. We went to the Nationals 1 year.
It's fast pitch
now. No. We did slow pitch. It was fun.
So did we. They made it fast, but yes, we still have that. We have an intrusive league that
you will be. But there's, so, yeah. I think the easiest thing to offer is really just basketball program. And I think, you know, summers would play soccer. You know, Marshwood and summers would do soccer. I would just, like, personally, I feel like we need to be better about our interview program and involve more kids because there are parents out there, like myself, who would probably over put our kids in, you know, I want my kids playing sports 3 times a year. I want them busy and I want them running all the time. But a lot of other parents have, there's other interests, you know. So I think intramurals really, really covers that.
Well, I like intramurals because like my oldest son in particular, we moved here when he was in fourth grade. When we lived in New York, we lived in the Hudson Valley, he couldn't breathe. He was out of school with asthma, that's why we moved.
Yeah.
And so when he got up here, he was not 8, 9, or older. But he'd never played. Because
yeah.
He couldn't breathe. So the intramurals were perfect for him. Because it did allow him to play on a team and do those things.
Yeah.
You know what I thought was really successful was, what's her name? I forgot her name, but she was running the soccer program and then she did the indoor.
Stephanie Wentworth.
Those were pretty successful, I thought.
Well, yeah, and that's the
And she got as many people, you have four teams.
Yeah.
So
yeah, well,
that
was the, yeah, the
intramural.
She took over the intramural.
It'd be really great to continue, even if it's, so even with that, I was just thinking in my head, even with basketball, if it doesn't turn out to be like a serious at night weekend thing, we can't make it happen, why not offer another like intramural like that?
Because then you're only offering it to the students.
that are on the school.
Good point.
Where does zoning that fit into that equation?
Your town, that's the problem if the school doesn't run. If the school runs it, great. School in a mirror is great, awesome.
And it's finding people like Stephanie who doesn't have any kids in the school anymore. So I don't know that she would be interested in doing that without pilot there.
But if we couldn't get a local program, that's what I'm saying. If we couldn't get a local program together.
Yeah. That's a
regardless
sure.
of if they go to the school or not, we couldn't get that to work, would we be able to do offer the students?
Well, that might be, you really need the help of the principal running the school for that.
So maybe it all starts with talking with him.
Yeah.
And once we get a more clear view, I guess, of what we're going to do, we can put it out on social media and let people know in the community or something. Mm-hmm. If we have coaches and space.
Yeah,
and
so
all
principal and coach.
I was asking because
I'm thankfully there.
I was thinking, you know, we have a program for the kids in the summer, but we don't have a whole lot in this community for besides yoga on Thursday nights for the adults.
That's the one too.
For the parents, for the elderly. Mm-hmm. So that's why I have the survey in there.
I've had a number of adults ask me, can we get gym time for an adult basketball night or pickup night?
So
or
even adults, you guys used to do it. They used to have, the men used to have a pickup night at the grade school.
Yes, so
once a week,
I
that was quite a while ago.
Yeah.
I don't remember.
Or
Pete
volleyball night.
Yep.
Like people have like, yeah, if you open it up, that you could charge.
I was gonna say that could be part
drop
of
in fee.
Fundraising.
Yeah.
Throughout the year.
So that is also another question. For the principal, because we really have to have school, we have to have the school behind us on that to be like, yeah, take this time. Or,
even in the summer, I mean, my husband plays baseball with my kids. I'm sure he'd love to play on a baseball league or a softball league, but we need permission either to use the ball fields in the evening or at the Legion or at the school,
mm-hmm.
but not by the fire department. Softball.
What about the grade school? We can use that.
Yeah. Well, we have to get permission from Sprout.
We also don't really want to be using a ball field right now. It's infested with Jumanji bugs.
What? What's
really terrible, huge, most important thing. You've been staying up to get
good. Okay, you need to tell us that.
Yeah, I already talked to the school. They're already working on it.
Okay.
Yeah, they're working. But they've already like infested it for the summer, so we have to stay off the field. But I have bought, Katie bought us bases so we can make the field in their little area over there, so
mm-hmm.
it's fine. But they're working on it, so it won't be an issue for us next year. I've already talked to Coach about it.
Yeah, it's kind of scary.
Yeah.
Has anybody got fun?
One.
Awesome.
You're outside, it happens. Or even, I know we had a couple people volunteer their services for the summer camp. Like the guy who owns Homegrown Eats, he's willing to teach people how to make mozzarella cheese. Maybe we open that up to do a sign up, open it to the community, like 15 people at a time make mozzarella cheese. And people who are interested in cooking can come in and take this class to the rec department. Oh, and then the guy at Sun Leather in South Berwick is willing to come in and teach people how to make things out of leather. And those would be additional opportunities for people to be involved in rec and maybe for us to do fundraising.
Yeah.
Yeah,
all right. Who wants to do that? Gabby?
Let's talk about that next month.
Yes.
Worry
awesome.
About
I can take the lead on
I mean, we really could do, you think about that, you could offer something, I don't know, once a month something.
Well, when my kids
like
were little,
so they can learn how to knit.
We did a summer enrichment.
PTO, and we had people come in, the Denise White House. She did stuff with the UNH, the cow barns. They would come in, bring a cow, and talk to the kids about, they would make ice cream.
Your grandmother did.
So is that our next meeting for everybody? Yes. Okay. 21st at 6:30.
I'm gonna try to reschedule, but I have a family event that night. I need to talk to my family so we can go.
So
6.
I'm sorry.
Six or 6:30? Does it matter to anybody else? We had 6:30 down in my book. I don't know. You had 6?
I had 6.
It doesn't really matter to me either. So maybe six. I just so 6? Let's do 6. Okay, 6 p.m. on the 21st.
Yep.
All right. Sounds good.
Seven 30.
Sounds awesome. Well.